Hello, everybody, and a very warm welcome to Crafters TV. My name's Ben Moseby. Thanks for joining us for our second and final show of Bank Holiday Monday here in the UK. We've been having a great day. Hopefully, you've had a great Easter break and you've enjoyed today. If you've just got back in from being out and about with the family, you are here ready to watch Monday Makers, a show where we've got tons lined up for you, actually. Lots to get through. There's loads of goodies that you can pick up on the show. We may or may not get round to them all over the course of the show, but things like the Mesmerising Glitter paste we're going to be looking at straight off the bat. Best ever price there. We've got the Spring Fairy Collection on the show. Best ever price. We've got the DuoColour pencils on the show. And not one, not two, not three, but four fantastic Monday mega deals. Also with a goodie bag thrown in for good measure as well. So we've got loads of great goodies to bring to you. And this is your final live show to pick up triple points. Mm-hmm. We've been doing it right across the bank holiday weekend. So make sure you shop, pick up those deals, get your extra points within Club Inspire. And of course, you can shop across the website as well, see all of those deals. It's a great time to be stocking up on all of those craft room essentials, things like your cardstock, things like your glues. If you need to get more ink pads, whatever it is, stock up now, get your triple points, and you will thank us later. Loads and loads, hopefully, of interactivity from you guys. Towards the end of the show, we are looking at doing another one of our now famous Sheena Q&A. So if you've got any questions that aren't sort of pertaining to the demo at hand, general questions, maybe you're stuck on a particular project, maybe you need some hints and tips from Sheena, whatever it is, get those questions in, and Radical Rachel, who is on the socials, will collate them and we will get those all written down and ready to go, I reckon, for the last 20 minutes or so of the show. So it's over to you on that one, but do get those questions in. We'll say a few hellos in just a few moments' time, but let's say the most important hello to the lady who is here to inspire, delight, and entertain. It is the one and only Sheena Douglass. How are you?
I am having a lovely day. It's been a laugh.
That's been a laugh today, isn't it?
Yeah, we had a good 2 hours earlier. Mm. Had a nice little chat in the break, and yeah. Looking forward to the next two.
Before we get on to the next two, obviously it's been great today because you're here, but you've brought the gang as well, haven't you?
The family's here as well. It's a family affair today,
We're here. Family affair.
It is, yep.
Now, there's one member of the family who doesn't want to say hello. I mean, would. Yeah.
Yeah, but she's camera shy, but, you know, she's vocal normally, you know. Believe me. Yeah, but she just didn't want to be in the camera. But the other one is is not camera shy at all. In fact, she thinks the whole world loves her.
Yeah.
And do you want to meet her?
Do you want to see Willow? Mm. Willow, come.
Oh, she's already.
Come.
Already.
She's camera shy. Hang on. This worked in rehearsal.
Willow,
come. Good girl. Come. Yay, come. Ready? Ready to say hello to everybody? Yes.
She's so cute.
Good ball girl. In mouth as well.
Good girl. Always with a tennis ball in her mouth. Yeah. Always. What a good girl.
What a good girl.
She's a good girl.
Look, there's mummy over there. Look.
Hey, Will. You're on TV. Yes.
You're famous.
Crafting.
Yeah. She's been keeping us royally entertained today with all of her tricks because she does so many.
She makes a better card than me. Yeah. Well. She's going to do the first one. She glitter paste over to her. Yeah. Yeah.
Look, Willow, there. Which camera are we in? Two.
Will.
There we go. Two. Yeah. We should keep her here for the rest of the show.
You know what we normally do? We normally have the ball posed like wherever they want her to look. It's like, you move the ball, she'll look there. Yeah, that's it. But yeah, she's a good girl. She's made lots of friends today. And bonded. Yeah, Uncle Ben and Willow. It's a love thing.
She can come again.
Yeah.
Right, we've got to put her down there because she's very expensive. Like, she's charging, you know, all sorts. So
Yeah, she'll be charging in a minute.
That's about 500 quid, that short appearance. Yeah. Well, there we go. Thanks for letting us show Willow, because she's the cutest little thing. She does all these tricks. She does, like, a little trick where she bounces the tennis ball in the air.
Yeah, she throws it back, doesn't she? That's called a nosy.
Nosy. Yeah. She goes to the middle. She does a spin around thing. Anyway, let's say a few more hellos. She's dribbled on the counter, but I don't mind that. It's all fun. Radical Rachel is with us on the socials. Sarah Brown says, hello again, my favourite people. Yes, that's you, Sheena. Oh, and Ben. Just kidding, Ben. The best presentation lead ever. Thank you. Sending hugs from a wet, rainy Melbourne, Australia. Well, if it's wet and rainy in Melbourne, there's no hope, is there? There's no hope. Pat says, hello, Ben and Sheena, all the wonderful CTV crew and all my lovely crafty friends. Carletta joins us from Arkansas. Karen Hughes says, hello again, everyone, from a wet and cold Sunderland. Hello also to Kat Butt, who says, hi, Sheena, Ben, team and crafties, loving a Sheena Monday. And Crafting Not Grafting by Hillary says, hello, everyone, from Holly and Hillary. So that's Hillary and Holly Collie. And I've just seen that there is a lot of love coming through on the socials for Willow as well. That's you, that is. There's a lot of love coming through. Her little face, she's so cute. Polly says, fabulous day to all from Brownstown, Florida. Right, come on, Ben, get on with it. If it was down to me, we'd have Willow on for the next 2 hours and we'd just play games and do cuddles and stuff. But we've got to do some crafting as well, so.
You've got to.
Nah, what are you going to do?
What are you going to do?
Mesmerising Glitter Paste. I'll show you the colours that you can get in this bundle and we'll get onto these with Sheena. As always, as Sheena's here, do ask the questions. If there's anything particular that you want to see, then make sure you holler and let us know. We'll make it a show all about you. If you've yet to pick up the Mesmerising Glitter Paste, grab these today. You will thank us because you're getting them at the best ever price that we've done them for. And you're also going to get them for triple points, but only here in the UK for the next, what, 6 and a bit hours. So go swiftly on these. If you've already bought them, you will know just how beautiful they are and how they are mesmerizing, and the fact that the light hits them in different ways and you're getting like a whole array of different beautiful colours across the 8 designs that you're getting in here. So usually, what, nearly £72, $88. Platinum price, £48 or $56 if you're shopping in the US. You have got the beautiful Equinox in there, which was Leanne's favourites, I think, wasn't it, at the launch of these? Because it was the one she was calling Equinox. You've also got the Wood Nymph. Craig had a different name for that, and I'm not quite sure. Did he call it a Wood Nymph? Something like that. The beautiful peacock and then that enchanted lake. The mermaid's tail, I know, was super popular individually, as was the mystical dream. But hopefully, you're seeing just on camera there, as I give that a little tilt, like the peacock, for example, you're seeing like sort of greens coming through initially, but then just a little tilt, you're seeing like greens and yellows coming through. That equinox, again, I'm looking that from upside down, very much sort of like a dark green, but on your screen right there, you're seeing golds, aren't you, and oranges coming through. So you really do have to get these home, I think, to appreciate them fully. But hopefully, if you're seeing that sort of colour change on your screen right now and you're thinking that's amazing, wait till you see them with your own eyes. Now, all of 8 of those you're going to get for that price. You can get them individually as well if you want to go down that line. But the best value for money is to pick these up in the bundle today with your triple points. And, of course, with Sheena being here, we're going to have a bit of a play with these. So we have gone and found some fun things for Sheena to play with. So that is what we are going to do over the course of the first part of the show. Sharon's just said, by the way, Willow is adorable. Hi, Ben, Sheena and the team. I've been tidying my craft room and I had a go at Draw the Line in the break. How did you get on? Let us know.
Yeah.
And Cindy says, I have commented in the past in regards to the glitter paste. CCs are absolutely the best in quality and colours and ease to work with. And Sherry Miller says, Ben, ask Sheena about learning to talk with the help of talk buttons.
Learning to talk with the...
help of talk buttons.
Help of talk buttons.
Oh, the audience is nodding.
But Maria knows. Oh, those, yes. Ah. That's spooky, right. So Maria bought these things. It was these little buttons that you can buy and you can program them.
Oh,
right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And you can actually program them to, like, say, you know, Mummy play, or need to go like outside or something like that,
or treaty.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, and you the thing is your little doggy, the different colours, knows when they hit them and they get what they want. Yeah, so that's what we got for Willow.
What?
Yeah.
So she'd just press it and then she would be like, Mummy play.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, there you go.
And then you go and.
And they go and they hit the thing. Yeah, but there was one night they all went off and. Yeah, and what? I was home alone. And what was it that was setting it off? It was something weird that was setting them off. Yeah. And I was absolutely panic-stricken. I don't know, I think it was the remote control was setting the things off. And I was home alone, and I was like, all I could hear was, "Mommy, play!" And I was like, "Whoa!" I was like, going to get like an exorcist in or something, you know? I was like, "What?" Yeah, they were pushing the door really quickly, yeah. And batteries out. Yeah, yeah. I ain't playing with them. Yeah. Yeah.
Fun when they work with your dog, but when they wake you up in the middle of the night, terrifying.
Oh, really? Yeah. What?
Oh dear. Anyway, thank you for that, Sherry, and thank you everyone for the lovely comments so far. We're going to have a play with these mesmerising glitter.
Yes, do you want to see some? Yeah. Well, should we just show you them first and then show you some samples, shall we? Should we have a play straight away?
Yeah.
Go on then, let's do it. Right, so I've got to tell you, if you're wondering, well, I'm going to show you what they look like to start with, because when you see what they look like, there's no doubt how phenomenal they are.
Yeah. Right?
They are incredible. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you like bling, then I don't know what more you could ask for, because
they
doesn't get any blingy at all. Oh, seriously, come on. Mm-hmm. Come on, hello.
Mm-hmm.
They're just packed with, it doesn't get any more intense than that.
No.
I don't have words. I haven't got words, look, seriously. That's the level of bling. So the next thing you want is how much cling? It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that cling. We've got the bling. Has it got the cling? I've got to tell you, my worst nightmare is showing up anywhere. Could be the TV studio, could be a CTV, and a crafter's mat has got some remnants of this stuff on it.
Oh, yeah.
Because if it has, it's going nowhere. It seriously is going nowhere. And I can try chiseling it off. I can try chipping it out, it's going nowhere. This stuff clings to anything. And once it's on there, it's not coming off. Oh, look what I've just done. That's me getting revenge, Debbie Robinson. Debbie Robinson, look, that's my gift to you. When's your next from Sheena? I'm gonna get a permanent marker. And I wouldn't do it to you. There you go, I'm taking that off. If you don't take it off now, believe me, it's going nowhere. So let me show you how it works. It's like, it couldn't be easier. So I'm going to pick out some colours. That one there, if you love that colour, is Enchanted Lake.
Okay.
The next one I'm going to use here is, these are all brand new. I can't believe they're going to be brand new. I don't know if I'm supposed to be using these brand new ones now, but it's, too late.
Too late.
Too late. Oh, it's like emeralds. It's like the Emerald City.
Which one's that one?
There's no place like home, Ben.
Oh.
Isn't that stunning? What was that? Sorry.
What's that one?
It's called. That one is. Yeah, good. Enchanted Lake. Oh, yeah, Enchanted Lake. But it is like the Emerald City, isn't it?
Yeah.
Look. Well, these have got chunkier bits in them, right? So that's why they look even more impressive than just glitter. They're not just glitter. It's like a disco ball crushed up. Multicolours in a jar.
Yeah.
Right. And this one here is the Mermaid's Tail. So this one is the one that you got that little preview of.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And this one is lots and lots of colours all together. Like that. I'm not going to show you all colour like this. We're just going to pick a few of them out. That again, can you see where I'm going? All the cool colours, because we're going to use a few together here on the on some silver mirror card. Because seriously, card, it just laughs at card, because this will go on to glass, wax, metal, it's just not
pretty
coming
much
off,
anything, isn't it?
Believe me, anything. And you don't have to worry about protecting it to keep it on there. It really isn't. Here it is. Equinox. Yeah. So this is the one. This is like it'd be a transformer called Equinox, something
yeah.
like that. Artemis Prime's like
yeah, that's it, yeah.
Equinox.
Autobots assemble.
Exactly.
Equinox.
Yeah, called Equinox.
Bumblebee.
Oh, I like Bumblebee's my favourite.
Me too.
We would definitely get that, wouldn't you? Mm. So what we're going to do, we're going to have a play, okay? So let me show you how they work. So basically, you just scoop a bit out, right? And you literally do that. That's it. Now, what you're going to do, you're not going to try and remove too much of this. You're going to put it on and you're going to, don't scrape it off. You know, with regular glitter paste, you put it on and then you try and scrape the excess off.
Yeah.
Well, if you do that, it's not the way to use this, because the bits are chunkier. You need to put it on and kind of leave it on, okay? Don't try and be too frugal with this, and don't worry about it, because we're still going to use the excess, but we're going to scoop it all up later. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And I am not worried about mixing these together, because I know I'm going to get my own incredibly cool, funky mix here. And what I'm seeing straight away here with that coppery Equinox. And that gorgeous teal colour is a kind of, you know, that verdigris, but in a really incredibly blingy, glittery way. So it's like disco verdigris. Disco, verdigris in the 70s. Yeah. Donna Summer does verdigris.
Donna Summer does verdigris.
Yeah, or maybe Gloria Gaynor will survive with verdigris. The whole thing there. Oh, and I've got a little bit of green in here. I'm hoping that when we remove this, you'll see all this. And this is, so what I would do, right, when we remove this, we're going to get all these colours. And I'm going for a whole, let's just pack loads of these on together for you so you can see the colours, as many colours in one hit, so that you can just see how just one colour looks amazing.
And you're not so fussed that you're putting your same knife back into different colours then?
I'm really not, Ben, no. Because they're so intense, they're so packed with that, that it really doesn't matter. And I'm hoping that when I'm going to mix these together, they're still going to look fantastic.
Yeah.
So what's going to be left on this is going to be cleaned up, and I'm going to get a little jar, and I'm going to put it all in. You know, like those little jam jars you get when you go into a hotel in
the posh hotels. Yeah.
Yeah. Keep them, and make sure it's the one with a really good lid on it, because you want the air. The thing is, with anything that's got an acrylic base in it, I've said time and time again, and that is just it. Doesn't matter who makes it, and they've got no secret, recipe to protect whatever they're giving you, other than airtight. That's it. So if you can put them in something that is going to keep them away from air, that's the secret formula. Keep air out of the mix, right? And that's going to last longer for you. So when these little guys are done, as soon as I'm done, I'm going to shut that down there, put that, keep the foil back on them, make sure I put the right lids on the right things, and put the lids on ASAP.
And if you haven't got the foil, a bit of cling film will do, right?
Cling film, absolutely. And you know what I would do as well? I said this before, is that acrylic paint artists keep them in like a plastic, container, you know, so that it doesn't. Oh, I've put that on the wrong one. Bear with. Oh, you know what I said? Make sure you put them on the right one. We'll sort that out later. Debbie Robinson,
Debbie.
More gifts for you later,
we'll
Debbie
show you
Robinson.
Debbie Robinson.
Yeah. Hey. So what they do is they put them in like a plastic container, that you would keep your food preserved in. So that it keeps the air away from them even more. So the more you can lock it and then lock it even further, the better it's going to be. Now, look at the colours in there.
That is incredible.
Look at all the colours showing through that. Isn't that just joyous?
Yes.
Now, me being frugal, I wouldn't put that on one card. No way I would put that on one card. That would be trimmed around the sides when it's dry. And I would put a quarter, and that would do four cards. That would be a topper on four cards, Ben. Matte and layer it, and maybe put an initial on it, or just make it just a ribbon or something like that, with maybe a medallion in the middle. But it would do four cards. That would not be a one card hit. I'd have to really, really, really like somebody to do that as one card. It would have to be a big card. Maybe if somebody was turning 60 soon or something like that.
Oh, yeah. So, do you know anyone?
On like the 6th of April or something like that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Good thing I'm not in denial of the age, isn't it? So that was, but that would maybe quarter it. But that's one thing. But that just maybe card, it just lasts. But all this here, right, what I would do, there's two things you can do. You could keep that there, or you could get a piece of black card even. Let's do this. You could clear it and put it in that jar. Or you could put it like on another bit of cord.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And then second gen.
See what, second try at it. And if you scrape and put this like this, sometimes there's enough on there to get another effect. And it's more of a distressed background effect with what you've got left on there. But it's broken. But, you could ink it up, or you could do something, it wouldn't be it would just be a background rather than the main thing. So either clean it up like that and put it in a jar, or do what I'm doing now,
But whatever you do, do it quickly, right?
Do it quickly.
Yeah.
As soon as it starts to dry, it ain't going anywhere. And also have that, like a container, like a bath ready for it.
Yeah.
To put that on, but boom, look at that.
That's really, really lovely, isn't it?
And that's the cleanup.
Yeah.
So that there again, you see, that would be where I'd be wearing,
yeah,
right? A black blouse with batwing sleeves. Mm-hmm. When I was busting me moves underneath that disco ball there in the, you know, dancing.
That does 70s. Scream 70s though, that doesn't it?
It is so 70s, isn't it?
Love
like
that.
Like the fabric with that glitter through it.
Yeah.
It is so 70s, yeah. So that's how you look like you're using a lot of your product, but you don't waste any of it. And that, if it goes on there, that's just what you could do just there. But also, definitely, definitely have like a bath like this ready for it. If you know one of those, you can get those little trays, those A4 trays and things that,
yeah,
you can store your things in, and just put that in there immediately. If you're not cleaning it like now, make sure that goes in there with soapy water, mm-hmm, and just let it, let the soapy water do its thing. And then you can wash it properly later, but just get the stuff off your stencil, because honestly, that is going nowhere, mm-hmm, if you don't do that right now.
Yeah, Debbie.
It's not going off. Shall we see it on a bit of glass or cork as well?
We, yeah, do you want to see another one?
Do you want to see something else, Nicola?
Yes, we do.
Alrighty, let's put that over there.
We're just getting ready. We can say hi to Linda Martinich, who says, OMG, fabulous. Oh, wow, says Jill. And Colin says, Sheena, you can't be turning 30 on both sides.
That's it, absolutely.
Love the tips on how not to waste any products, says Cindy. And Jerry says, banner day today. Two shows with Ben and Sheena and my Enchanted Ocean showed up at my doorstep between the shows. I am a happy camper. We might take a look at that as well for you a little bit later on if you have got the Enchanted Ocean. In fact, we are definitely going to be doing that a little bit later on. Sarah Morley's just asking, Sheena, as we get onto the next demo with you, what do you use to stick a stencil down?
To stick a stencil down, right. So the low-tack tape is one option.
Yep.
Or stick and spray. Not stick and stay, stick and spray.
Okay.
But if you use the stick and spray, what will happen is it's going to leave a residue on your stencil, yeah?
Yeah.
So you might want to remove that residue with stick away every now and again.
Okay.
If it's just a tiny little bit, because you're just going to do a little spritz of it. Mm. If it's cod, you hardly need to do any spray. Just a very quick, like, woo, 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 like that. Yeah?
How much?
Woo, 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 like that.
Woo, 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 woo.
And it'll just cling to there. If it's glass or something, that's not going to be strong enough to hold a bit of mylar that's this strong around a curved surface. So I would use the tape to pull it around there. Yeah?
Okay.
Yeah, that's it. That's basically it. So shall we try a bit on a bit of cork?
Oh, let's do it all. Yes, come on,
yeah,
cork.
Yeah, we'll do a bit more there. Let's try different colours. Shall we go, what colours have we not used? Shall we go, well, I love Equinox.
Let's use Equinox.
Let's use that and we'll use a bit of, what's this one? Rose Garden. I beg your pardon.
I never promised you a rose garden.
Along with the sunshine.
You've got to be
there's
a
gotta
little,
be a little rain sometimes. Did you see what I did there? Yeah, I'll come back, you hear you? Okay, right, so we're going to do that.
I'm just laughing that Willow is sort of giving you, I don't know, sort of glancing over.
She's looking like,
singing.
Oh, mommy's singing again.
Yeah.
Oh, what a show. She's like, oh. She's
I can't
like, you
take
know, Kevin
her anywhere.
And Perry. Kevin, oh.
Mommy, sure.
Oh, she's been, I'm actually physically here and seeing her do it.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
She's like, I did my little bit, all professional, on yeah. the TV, and Mum's singing again.
Oh, she's singing again. You want to live with him, Ben. So, yeah, we'll do that one. We're not going to see the one that we're just like, you know, we're not mentioning it again.
No.
But I'm thinking it would look quite nice on the cork, don't you think?
Yeah.
So, because it's kind of like a really nice, warm, rosy kind of gold. Look at that. So I've got this. What I've done is I've used a bit of tape doubled up there just to anchor it a little bit because there's no way to get this stencil tape down. Mm. Yeah. So I'm going to attempt.
Okay. And wherever we lay this on whatever we lay it, are we just then, it's just going to dry naturally, right?
It is just going
to
air dry. And it dries quite quickly, Ben.
Yeah.
Doesn't take long at all.
Okay.
You know, a couple of hours and it's going to be pretty much, you know, rock hard, indestructible, to be honest. Debbie Robinson. Well, she is the bling queen, isn't she? I mean, there's glitter. Chances are, you know, if it's ink, it's a fair cop, you know.
Yeah, but it's a fair cop, Gov.
So we'll pop that there and then try to remove it cleanly.
Oh, that's awesome.
That works, doesn't it? Mm-hmm. That looks pretty cool. Yeah, I like that.
That's really cool.
So it's transformed that little jar there into something that can, you know, quite, and it'll bling up even more when it dries a little, because like everything, the solution with acrylic is always a little bit more hazy when it's still wet.
Yeah.
And it'll become much more vivid and clear and sparkly once that dries. The other thing you can do, so I'm just going to try and take that off there, like that. Because it's only one colour, I haven't mixed the colours, I'm going to put it straight back in the jar, but straight back. Don't put dried stuff in there, only the stuff that's new and hasn't started to, you know, go hard. Yeah, because you don't want to get crunchy, like dried up bits in back in there.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to just pop that there. And then the last little thing I wanted to show you is you don't even need a stencil. What I think looks really cool is I was doing a candle I did.
Oh, yeah.
And I've got it at home. And I just basically, instead of using like a stencil or a tape or whatever, I think it looks really good if you just use the paste and your...
you just pop them on your finger.
And just kind of, you know, it looks very kind of like kind of under the sea kind of look. You know, you can, and you can make it look kind of like seaweedy or... corally or kind of foliage, you know, just drag it up and draw the line again. So if you put it quite quite thick at the bottom,
yeah,
and then thinner at the top, and you can mix the colours in. Let me go around a little bit more. I think it looks quite quite organic, doesn't it?
It does look organic. And you can still burn the candle, can't you?
And
you can
still burn
the
candle.
I know a few people are worried about that.
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah, that's very cool.
And you know, this could be on furniture, could be anything like that that you want to just bling up or on a picture frame. So you don't have to use it super, super thick, but it looks quite fairy-like and enchanted, doesn't it? And you know, you could just fade in up the, and again, mix the colours in if you want, but I really do like that look.
A little Christmas candle, maybe.
Yes, gorgeous, yeah. Pretty, just another suggestion.
Love it. Excellent. Stuff. Lots of love coming through. Dawn just saying, hi, Ben and Sheena, just unpacked my enchanted ocean. OMG. I'm glad I got three tote bags to hold all the stuff. Got my colour ink pads that change colour. Oh, yeah, the duet blooms. And Jill just saying, happy birthday, Sheena, for the 6th. You're a youngin' yet, says Jill. We've got some Monday Mega Deals. Before we show you the Monday Mega Deals, if it's stencils you're after... then these are also on the best ever price. BEP, £32 or $40 is your price on this. 15%, less another 20%. And if you're getting the Mesmerising Glitter paste, why not pick up the stencils? And it's six packs, if you like, but in each set you do get three, giving you your 18. So in this set, you've got your 8 by 3.8, so 8 by 4, pretty much the size of the stencils here. This one's your interlacing trio, so you've got three fabulous designs within that set. Love this one, which is your contemporary trio. You've got sort of like star designs here. You've got like, the rising sun, and then like a zigzag effect on the three that you've got within that set. And then your elaborate trio is more sort of swirls, sort of... quite sort of vintage effects, really, that you can create with the three designs in there. And then the other three packs, again, you get three stencils, but you'll remember these from when we did launch the Mesmerising Glitter Paste. You get your larger stencil, which is your 8.5 by 8.5, and then you get the smaller icon, and then also the border as well. So this one gives you that beautiful design here alongside the sort of Greek key effect you've got in your icon, and then in that slightly longer border design. Then you're going to get this one, which is called Laurel Leaves. So it's all about those beautiful leaves, again, which is quite nice. You've got the slightly bigger
outer portion on each of these stencils, so you've almost got that buffer zone, so you're not worried about getting your glitter paste where you don't want to get it on your particular projects. That's all about those beautiful leaves, as I say, and then within the set you're going to get your three-piece sun rays, which is this beautiful rising sun effect, which again you get in your 8.5 by 8.5, and then your smaller icon and banner. All of those, again, the best ever price and triple points today as well, which is incredible, really. So £32, $40, you're going to bag yourself 96 points or 90 points if you're shopping in the US. Loads of Money Mega Deals for you as well. The one of which I do need to show you, the first Money Mega Deal, is incredible. People have found it. It's flying. You're shopping because... this is your stash and stack storage box with crafting essentials. You have to do the chucky around thing with this, don't you? Just to show that, you know, it's not going anywhere. Even if you chuck it around, I mean, don't keep doing it, he says, doing another one. But these are super sturdy. You've got your locks on the side there as well. Okay, so it's going to keep everything in place. The whole point is everything that you've got inside there is going to stay in the compartments, in the designated compartments that you put them in, because you've got choice. You've obviously got the indentation in the lid there, which is marvellous for you if you're buying multiples of these. They're going to stack absolutely perfectly for you. But as we come inside, you will see, and this one's not been divvied out, but you've got all of these tabs, right? And these tabs will simply go wherever you want them to go. So you can have loads of small spaces, should you wish, or you can have larger spaces if you want to be able to do that. Indeed, if you want to take them all out, if you just want a larger surface area to store, you know, bigger items, you can do that too. You've got total customization with the stash and stack boxes. The brilliant thing about this deal, though, is for £24 or $32, you're not just getting the box. No, no. We're also going to be giving you a set of your misters, so you get four of those included in the bundle. Also, you're going to get pokey tools, always very handy, two of those included. Is it all of this? This is incredible. You're also going to get your metallic pigment ink pad in the bronze. On top of that, we're also going to give you one of our original tape pens. So that is the standard tape pen in the original size. So you're getting your 22 meters, 72 feet of stick within that one. Then we're going to give you the beautiful velvet ribbon, which came from the Wild at Heart collection. Then on top of that, we are going to give you the fantastic ballpoint glue pens. These are particularly good if you like to do little embellishments, or maybe you want to create some sort of sparkly writing. You can lay your glitter down over the top. You can use things like your gilding flakes with these as well. You lay it down blue, and once that blue begins to disappear, that's when this is tacky and you can start sticking with it, laying down all of those fabulous mediums. And on top of all of that, we're also going to give you one of our spray bottles to use in conjunction with your station, your cleaning station for your stamp. So everything is included there. And like I said, you can see the size of the box here as well. If you want to take out the central compartments, you can. You can just basically store in here whatever you want. And quite handily, just to give you a few more ideas, I know so many people bought multiples of these for craft and then bought more to store in things like stationery, things like fishing equipment, things like, you know, those drawers that you take up at home with cables, and you can store them in here. Fabrics, if you've got kids, you know, and they've got those smaller toys like the building blocks. If you've got kids, you've got that particular doll who's got loads of outfits and shoes which get all over the place. These are absolutely perfect for storing all those bits and pieces in. It's a great price today. It really, really is. However, snap it up whilst you can, because whilst these boxes will still be in stock tomorrow, you will not be able to get them at the price you're seeing on screen, because the Monday Mega Deals, as I'm sure you're aware, are a 24-hour only deal, and you're only going to get your triple points for another 6.5 hours here in the UK. So it's midnight wherever you are, the triple points ends. So let's give you opportunity to get your carts and your baskets checked out. So much to bring you over the course of the next hour and a half, including, as we've mentioned, our Q&A later on. So get those questions in. Anything you want to ask Sheena, anything you want to ask Willow, we can get her on the sofa as well. I'll look after her. Right, get the questions in and we'll come back in about 3 or 4 minutes' time. In the meantime, we're going to hear from Craigle Bagel.
I like to get up, chill, relax, get a cup of tea, then get myself sorted. And if I'm presenter, I'll write all my notes. If I'm the demonstrator, I'll get my prep out, have another look at it, make sure that everything is the way it needs to be for the show, do the show. Then what I'll do is I'll grab something to eat, then have another look at the sheets again, making sure the next show's all good to go. Then we do that show, tidy. I always like to make sure that the area is nice and tidy, either for myself the next day or then jump in the car, head home. I will quickly unpack what I need to unpack, and then I get on that sofa as quick as I can. As soon as we go live, I love that within our live shows, I always get the butterflies. As soon as we get that countdown in our ear that we're just going live, butterflies kick in, and within about 10, 15 seconds, I'm going. Butterflies have gone, and we just enjoy the show. Early riser. Oh, shower in the morning. Tea. Oh, savoury breakfast. Masterclass. My mobile phone. Oh, anything with chicken. Currently, it is the weekend, Blinding Light, and it has been for about a couple of years, and I still love it. Apart from jumping in the car, chilling on the sofa, watching TV.
Come in, check my emails, then lay the shows out in the studio, set pack shots up, then I will get new poles, pick shows, solve any problems that need solving. We deal with other teams where we receive marketing suites, we receive boards, we pick samples to send to Hobbymaker, we pick samples to send to QVC. We will take the previous shows out of the studios, set the new shows up. We do floor manage occasionally, not all the time, making sure that the craft expert presenters have everything at hand that they need. Anything that they haven't got during shows, we will run about and get the products for them. Think on a morning when it's really quiet, I can get more done when there's nobody else in the building. Night owl. Morning. Coffee on a morning, tea the rest of the day. Savoury. Normally lunchtime. Craft along. Mobile phone. Christina's chicken wrap. Barry White. You're my first, my last, my everything. Go home and make the tea.
Geronimo, here we go for the next next item in the show, which is the Timeless Leaves collection. We've got best ever prices across so many goodies on the show, half price deals as well. And as I've said, 24-hour deals for you too. So you are going to have to be quick across a lot of goodies. I mean, this deal is just ridiculous, isn't it? This is ridiculous. The Timeless Leaves three-piece selection, £15 or $17.60 if you're a Platinum member. And you're still going to get your triple points on it. So actually, you're getting more points than you would have got in the first place, but you're still getting a... well, £20, $23 discount. That's even before your Club Inspire discount on top of it. You're going to get... now, the only thing that you don't get in this collection is... initially, there was a die with this, wasn't
there? There was, yes. And an embossing folder.
Yeah.
So that sold out, and it sold out individually as well. Mm. So they're just the leaves. But you know what? Even I can cut these leaves out.
Yeah.
And I'm rubbish at cutting out. So
oh, yeah.
You can still do the things. The only thing is the embossing folder that you're going to lose the vein in the leaf and the background. Mm. And I've got a little card that I think looks really cool. We're going to do... that's just the stamp.
The designs that you're going to get in here, I mean, they are absolutely fantastic. If I flip that over so you can see the design in the leaf there. So this one is called your Spring Blossom. I always say this every time we bring this collection, and I absolutely love the fact that you've got your main image, obviously, that you can stamp on the front of your project. But I love the fact that you've got like a smaller stamp that will then work really nicely on like an insert on a little corner on the inside of your card. I think it just kind of wraps everything up really nicely. But again, the artwork is absolutely incredible. That sort of window into the countryside through that beautiful leaf, and then you get a whole host of different sentiments to go with it as well. So you've got Hello Spring. You've also got Spring Never Breaks a Promise and Time for New Beginnings. You brighten my hours like the first spring flowers. Aww. Next. I love this one because this is called Nature's Harvest. I love the squirrel. And I think I said to you the first time I saw this stamp, I thought the squirrel was kind of resting on a walking stick.
It absolutely looks like that after I've drawn it. It was actually the continuation of the trunk of the tree.
Yeah.
But he looks like he's a little old wise squirrel.
Yeah.
Resting on his walking stick. So even I think that now when I drew it.
Yeah.
So yeah, he does look like he's leaning on his walking stick. Absolutely.
You've got.
I should have put a little monocle on his eye or something.
Yeah, maybe.
I could draw that on.
Yeah. Maybe like, a top hat.
Yeah, like Patrick Moore again.
Yeah. I can only ever think of Patrick Moore now when he was. Do you remember Games Master? Because he was the Games Master.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, I do. Yeah.
Why is he in contact?
He's a guy now.
And a Games Master.
Yeah, give me a little squirrel.
Today's game is Pac-Man.
So you got embrace change, catch a leaf and make a wish, harvest nature. So there's your squirrel. So you've got your springtime blooms, you've got your autumnal nature's harvest, and then you've also got your summer days, which is a trip into the orchid, isn't it? Orchard,
it is.
Rather. Orchard.
It is.
Orchard.
The harvest.
The harvest.
Arr.
So you've got your beautiful apples there, and lots of stunning sentiments like the sunniest memories are those made with you, and always be as kind as the summer breeze that embraces flowers and caresses.
I love that collection. I've got to say, at that price, that's just, it's ridiculous. You know what, it's all year. If you want an all year collection of really pretty stamps, and I'm going to show you a card that you can make with all those those four stamps, and it'll work with all four, and you can gift these. If you make a little set of notelets like this, people will love you for it. You know, I didn't realize until Maria's mum writes old school notelets and thank yous and people and to our friends. And the joy that people who don't craft, when you give them a gift like that, it's worth such a lot. And when you make them yourself, you don't realize that, but honestly, to make them to sell or to gift them, it's huge. So that would make a really nice gift for through the whole year, because you've got every season represented.
Yeah.
And for what, £20 for that, and less if you're platinum.
It's crazy. And Cindy just said, crazy good price on Sheena's lovely timeless leaves. I absolutely love this collection. And Candice says, I've just coloured the spring leaf last night. Love this set. Making a card for my aunt and mom today using the spring leaf. And I cannot wait to see what Sheena's demo is.
Okay. Right. So what I was thinking is, what size is this? Oh, see, right, I should measure it. I just did it by it. It's just short of a 6x6 card. So what I did was I folded an A4 card, you know, and then squared it off. So A4 piece of paper.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it'll fit in a smallish envelope, so it's not going to cost a lot to post. So what I've done is I've stamped it, and I actually found that you can just get that leaf on the largest rocker block. Just squeeze it on there. The little bit of the bit around that overhangs slightly, but the actual stamp bit fits on. And I've put it off the side of the rocker block. And what I wanted to show you, and I'm not even going to try and cover it up, is there's a couple of bits there that I hadn't inked it properly.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not even going to pretend that I did, because what I'm going to also show you is why you want your art liners, just to put little, just so that you can just get yourself out of jail, just like that, and just follow the little bits and fill in those little broken lines of the little bits that if you've missed a couple of lines like that, it's not the end of the world. You don't have to stamp it again or go, oh, I've wasted that bit of card. Just fill the lines in, fill the broken lines in. And if you, big tip is use the narrower pen because it looked like a paler ink. If your ink, I didn't use black, I used, was it Flagstone? So this ink in this pen is a black ink, but if you use the very fine one, like I've used the 0.05, it will not look as black as if I'd used a thicker nib. That makes sense?
Yeah, absolutely.
So that is good now. Now I'm good to go. I'm good to play. I can colour that in. And I've also stamped the Time for New Beginnings. And what you can, so that would work with any of them. And it's the leaf just coming on the thing like that. But we're going to make it look a little bit funkier. And this here is where I'm going to stamp that little smaller image as well that Ben was saying. And this is also where you can stamp that little greeting. Or you could put it up here where whoever's going to write has got room to write the card. So I think it just makes it, just finishes everything off. So I'm going to use, I think I'll use just my aquas because even though I'm using these ones that aren't available now, you can get all of the aqua colours still in the individual set. So that's fine. So let me show you how we can colour these in. I'm just going to look and refer to my, I'm going to use red violet. So I'm going to tell you the colours because you will still get all of these in the individual pens in the sets. Okay, so red violet I'm going to use for my cherry blossom. I'm going to use a green, and I'm definitely going to be using olive at some point because it is my favorite green, and I'm going to use this green pen, so that'll work there. And I want a blue for the sky, and I'm probably going to use peacock, but much paler, which is, that's teal. Bear with please while I find a pen. This is like, you know, this is like this was like when I did the shop demonstration, it would become like pantomime. It was behind you, and it was like a group interaction. Right, but good.
All How many people were watching the demonstration?
Oh, Ben, it was absolutely, well, I said I'd do another one at Evesham because it's on the doorstep, and I couldn't believe it. It was amazing. It was absolutely packed. The shop was packed.
Standing room only.
It was. We had, everyone was sat, and we had to like ask the people who were there in the morning if they wouldn't mind not saving their seats so people in the afternoon could get in, because the whole of the, I don't know if you know the shop, but all of the classroom area was full. We had seats full. Every seat was taken, and people were standing at the back.
Wow.
And then that everyone rotated for the afternoon as well. And it was like that all day. It was absolutely packed, and it was like that, like back in the day, you know, way back. It was amazing, Ben. It was fabulous. So thank you to everybody who came. We had an amazing day. Maria was there with me all day, and we just had a great laugh, great time, and it was great fun.
Do you enjoy doing that as much as you enjoy doing the live TV stuff?
Oh yeah, it was lovely. You know, I love the TV, and it's just seeing people and meeting people, and that's the best bit, I think. Don't you agree? What we do?
Oh
is
yeah.
Like we were just saying, we love doing the shows because we genuinely enjoy each other's company. We like the company. We have fun, and we hope it comes across.
Yeah.
And we hope you enjoy us having fun, because, you know, I think that's an important part of crafting, isn't it?
I'm desperately trying to get down to one of these days. I keep tagging onto everybody. I keep saying, oh, like, you know, Debbie, next time you go down, you know, wink, wink, nudge, nudge, I'll come and, you know, help out. Now I'll make the teas or something, or hand out.
Oh, Ben. Definitely.
Sheena, if you need a helping hand, I'll be there.
Oh, yeah, for sure. No, yeah, definitely, invited. Ben. Yeah, we'll get that. I think I said I'd do one in July. In Evesham again. So, yeah, we'd love you to come and
come
to you then. Right, okay. You heard it here, everyone?
Yeah.
All right, okay. Evesham. Here we go. Yeah.
That's what I mean, though, Nicola. I'm quite happy to do that. Like, rove around the audience, getting questions.
That would be brilliant. That would be great.
I don't have to be, front and centre. I'll just be there helping out, chatting. I'd love to get down and chat to everybody.
Oh, you know what? They would love it. Everyone would love it, because it was such a good atmosphere and really good, you know, spirit. Good. Everybody was up for it, you know. And you know me, I have to have a laugh. That was important, that it wasn't just a starchy kind of a dim. We had a good laugh, and we had a lot of interaction, and it was great. We had a great time.
Right, well, you had it here first then. July the what?
I don't know yet. We said just July. We haven't got the date firmed up. As soon as we do, we'll you're going to hear it first, Ben.
I'll be there.
Fabulous! Yay!
A long way for me to go, but you know.
Well, you can come and we'll meet your coffee, Ben. I'm like 10 minutes away from there.
Well,
even
I know
10.
You, it's all right for you.
Yeah.
I'll take the company helicopter.
I'll be fine, Ben. I only live 10 minutes. But you'll be all right. Yeah, fine.
Oh, Becky Swan's got the company helicopter that weekend. Hasn't she got her own helicopter? Oh, she borrows
ours. Well, we've got the helipad in the garden at, Cooper Douglas Towers. So,
have you?
Yeah, we've got the helipad at the back, so you'll be fine.
Yeah, okay. Good to know.
Yeah, you're all right. Yeah, get good welcome from Willow.
Oh, exactly right now.
You know that, you'll be all right there.
We're besties now, we are.
Yeah, you are, besties.
Yeah, besties. Yeah.
You didn't even get the usual bark, you know, the initial...
No, from what you were saying, she's a bit barky. I've not really...
Yeah, no, you didn't.
I mean, I haven't had that. Oh, she's barked at Jamie every time he walked past. But, if I was a dog, I'd bark at you every time as well, Jamie, to be fair. So,
He obviously looks threatening. It's that evil glint in his eye, you know, that...
It's the way he walks past going,
oh, James, he's a bad'un. She's funny. She usually just, that default's just like, danger, danger. Yeah. So we've got the pink done there. But you see how quick that is? Just one little bit of pink scribbled on there. Mm. We'll do this, we'll put the sky in, and then we'll show you how we can make that look a little. And it's the same deal. Just find your colours, a little bit of water, and then just go for it. So we're going to go a little bit darker at the top. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to... still, but not completely, undiluted. We're still diluting the colour. So I'm going really quickly because there's always stuff, more things we want to show you, even though, we have got the luxury of all this time. I'm still always aware that there's more to show. We can, I think if we had a residential, Ben, that'd still be more to show
you. That's
it.
Helen Walsh says you were class in Evesham, apparently.
Oh, bless you. Thank you. The audience were class. It doesn't work without everybody making it work, does it? And that was including the staff. The staff were fantastic. Rachel and the guys were brilliant as well. They put a lot of work into making it work, too.
Cindy's just asking for future ones, and the one that you've just done. Is it a case of making reservations to those when they happen at the store?
No, they don't. But what they did was, this time, they did goodie bags. And they had really good, little goodie bag deals and things like that. So at least if you knew you had your goodie bag there ready to go, they knew roughly how many people were going to go beforehand to give them an indication of how many seats and things to set up. So that kind of helped them. But then they all sold out, and then they had to make more, and then they had to make more again. So So you don't have to reserve. You don't have to. It's not a book a place. You just come along.
Yeah,
and obviously the earlier you get there, the more chance you have of getting a seat.
Yes,
and closer to the front, so you can heckle more.
Love a bit of heckling.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Well, you don't. You just get more jobs because you get more of where did I put that again? Can you do that? Right. When this comes out of the Gemini, can you just catch that there? Because then when it comes out, it's coming out towards you. So if you just, grab that, that's great for me. And you just get jobs, really.
And do they have the camera set up there as well, then, so you can watch?
They've got
an
overhead camera.
Cool.
What we'll do is next time we'll take our mic so that we can get that a bit better. So they didn't have the mic set up this time, but we'll definitely make sure that that's sorted for the next time.
Yeah.
It was... it was really, 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 really great. And, it's when we saw how many people turned out, because that's what it used to be back, 6-7 years ago. Mm. So we were really very, very, very pleasantly surprised at how many people were there on the day. And we were thrilled. It was fabulous. Really, really great.
Oh. It's like you had a great time.
Yeah.
And it sounds like everyone else did as well from the comments.
So I'm just doing this here, Ben, like this. Just what I'm doing is I'm just putting a wash over these hills. And normally the hills in the distance are a little bit more muted, not as vibrant, so less colour in them, not as exciting. So I'm not... I think it's going to take me a little bit longer than I'd hoped to finish this, because I want to show you how we can make this look 3D as well. Even though we haven't cut it out, I want to make it look like you have.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
What were the other designs that you did that had, because was it snowflakes you did that was similar
the
to this?
The snowflake, yeah, yeah, was the one that we did, that was like the, like based on the, what's it called? The, like the picture in picture, double exposure, that's it, the yeah. photography technique, yeah, called double exposure. So.
Very clever.
Yeah, it's a great technique. I really like that look. And it, I think it just lends itself well to stamping.
Yeah.
For sure. It makes it more interesting, I think. It just, it's, and for nature and scenes, I think it works really well. So I've got this almost sorted here.
Yeah.
And then, so what I'm going to do is just try and change slightly the colour of these fields a little bit. And I want to really mute down the colour of the sky slightly. I need to put some brown for the branches of the tree.
Yeah.
Which is that one there. So we've gone full on bright colour here, but we can mute it if we want to. It's easy enough done with them. You know, you can use grey and black, which we can show. I'd like to actually show that if we have a chance to do that.
Very pretty. Just to say, in the second hour of the show as well, we are doing our little Q&A. I believe we've got about three or four questions so far. So if you've got a question for Sheena, you want to fire in, feel free to. And I know our Rachel is currently popping together a list of questions. What will happen, you see, is which has happened in previous weeks, we'll get sort of five or six questions, and then when we sit down to do the questions, we get about 20 questions come in, and then we never get round to them all. So if you have got one, I will do them in an order of first come, first serve. Fair's fair and all that.
Yeah.
So
I'm just toning down those distant hills a little bit, Ben.
Yeah.
Just to make them look a little bit darker, a little bit more, less colourful. Just push them back a little bit so it's less sunny back there. And then what I can also do is just make these little things here a little bit more in silhouette, these trees a little bit, so it's less full colour. And I can take a little bit on this cherry tree, make it a little bit more shade there, so we see how it looks a little bit less vivid. Yeah,
almost halfway through, Sheena.
I know. Where, how does that happen?
Oh, I don't know.
Well, you know what, Ben, at least we don't struggle to fill the time, do we? Either crafting or talking, Ben, we never have a problem with either, do we?
We could go on forever, couldn't we, eh?
We could, Ben. Shall we will we be able to continue with this one, or
Yeah, probably. I think so.
You think? Is that often, is that Nicola?
It's not my call.
Is it Nicola's call?
It's Nicola's call. She's just
a bit Nicola
of a...
says yes. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay, because I think that looks much better at the bottom. I don't know about you, but I want to darken a bit of this up here.
Yeah.
And I think it'll look much more impactful if we can do that.
Well,
that's my thinking.
We shall continue to do that the other side of 6 o'clock. Sheena will return. With the, I haven't got to Sean Connolly. I didn't. No, if it was Sean Connolly, I'd say 6 o'clock. Oh yes, after six with Sheena. Yes, Mitch, Molly, Benny. Just want to quickly show you the boards, though. Of all of the designs that you're going to be getting in this collection, £15. It's not upside down. Have you seen that? Come on. Which sentiment are you looking at? That one? Well, that is upside down. I'm showing you the image that you're going to be creating with these. There you go. You can read all of the different sentiments now if you want to be pedantic. 1520 or 1760 is your platinum price here. There's the squirrel. There we go. There he is, standing on his head. And you've also got in this set the... you've got the beautiful cherry blossom as well. Triple points across all of these, as we said, and the platinum price is incredible. £15.20 or $17.60. It's triple points on everything, on this show, on the previous show, and of course across the website. But if you want to get those extra points, you will have to make sure that you have shopped before midnight wherever you are, because the triple points ends at midnight, so get shopping. Welcome. If you've just joined, the second hour of Monday Makers. We are in the midst of a demo with the Timeless Leaves collection. But if you have just joined us, you won't know that we've got four Monday Mega Deals that you need to be having a little bit of a sneaky peek at and snapping up. We have got the stack and store. We've got a great deal on the rocker blocks. We've also got a goodie bag, an embossing folder goodie bag. If you want to see what's in that, holler, let me know, shout up, and we can certainly have a little bit of a look in there. And as far as collections are concerned as well, some fantastic ones. We are going to have a look at the Enchanted Ocean collection over the course of this show too, and have a bit of a look back at one of the demos from the launch last week. Plus your questions, anything you want to ask Sheena, any projects that you're stuck on at the minute, any kind of tips that you're looking for, feel free to fire those questions in. I believe we've got about five or six lined up now, but that doesn't mean that you can't get yours in. And we'll do those the other side of 6:30. So lots to look forward to. Pat's just joined us saying, I just love watching Sheena colour. I'm supposed to be doing my bills, but I stopped to watch her colour. It's so relaxing. Yeah, and a lot more fun than doing bills, I suppose, as well. Hi to Amber, who's joined us as well, who says, I love it. And Gaz is in saying, hi, Ben, Sheena, and all the crew, and all my crafty friends. Shall we get back to it, Sheena?
Yeah, we're nearly done, Ben. Nearly there. So what I've done is I've stamped this leaf, and it's just a nice little off-the-page kind of like where you can stamp any of the leaves. And what I've done is I stamped it using the extra-large rocker block. Okay. Mm-hmm. And what I'm doing is I'm just going around the outside with a little bit of this dark grey on the from the pens, just to darken around the outside. It just makes the leaves look a little bit more kind of aged. And if you look on the leaves, you'll see I've given it a little bit of hatching. Can you see the line work around there? Just gives it that vignette look. Mm-hmm. It just, again, makes it look more like a... ties in the image in the center to the actual leaf itself.
Yeah.
A little bit more. So I'm just going around there and adding a diluted version of that gray ink around that. And don't worry if you go over your nice pink cherry blossom. I think it doesn't spoil it. I think it adds to it. Yeah. And then what I'm going to do to finish it, which we nearly do, I'm going to add a tiny touch of white, and we're going to add a little faux shadow, drop shadow to it as well, to make it look like we've actually 3D'd it. Even though you haven't got those dyes, we can make it look like we've got a little bit of movement to it. So that then, you take a little bit more time and fade that out a little bit more neatly than I did there. But it's, I think that looks way better,
yeah,
personally, than it did. I'm going to put a little bit of white on the, where'd I put that white? Right there. So this pen that you got with the Bella Luna, it's going to come back, Leanne said, as just a staple.
Ooh,
item.
Is that similar to the one in the...
In the pack as well, the sketch pack?
Yeah, the sketch pack.
Yes, yeah. So it's such a good pen that, you know, the gouache and the pen that I asked for in that set as well, in the Bella Luna.
Yeah.
That we said, that Leanne said, we can have that back as just a core product, which is fab, because I use a white pen all the time. Need that, thank you very much.
And I feel a lot of people are always searching for that particular pen, aren't they?
They are. It's a great pen. So what I'm going to do now, Ben, is I'm going to use this paler grey, maybe that grey, mix it a little bit of grey in together. Not too dark, start lighter. And then I'm going to use my brush, and I'm going to just follow the shape of this here and just take the little, see that I'm following the shape of the leaf, but coming out a little way.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, and then coming down, and then I think I'm just popping that a little bit like that. And then coming in, so I'm not doing it exactly symmetrical. I want it to look like the leaf has got a little bit of movement to it. And then I'm gonna pop that there. And then pop that there.
Wendy's just messaged to say she got brave and sent the studio a picture of a card she made with the squirrel stamp.
Oh, cool.
Wendy, we'll have a look at that if we get chance.
Absolutely.
And what size brush are you using, asks
I'm using Sealy. The number 6 Royal and Langnickel.
Yes.
That's the one I use about 90-odd% of the time, to be honest. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to be really brave and come out and do this like way away there like that.
Mm.
So it looks like that's lifted right up from there. And I'm gonna, can you see how just being really quite quirky with this, it looks like you've got that leaf all kind of like twisted and turned and lifted up from the background a bit.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's very, kind of very good.
What the French would call trompe l'œil.
We call it what?
Trompe l'œil.
Trompe l'œil.
Which is the fooling of the eye. So when you go to these big posh stately homes and they've got like false like kind of gardens, you know, where you look like you're looking into a terrace and it's just painted on the wall or whatever.
Yeah.
And or urns on the wall or statues and they're not really there, but they look like they are.
Trompe l'œil.
Yeah, trompe l'œil. Then that is fooling of the eye. So yeah. Lawrence Llewellyn loved a bit of trompe l'œil.
Oh, did he?
Yeah, he loved a bit of that. Yeah.
Good old Lawrence.
Yeah. So then that was just that little trick I wanted to show you. So if you look at
very clever. Oh, bless you again.
Leaf looks like you've got it curled up. Sorry. Yes. Leaf looks like you've got it curled up behind the mat. And I think I've made myself completely clear on that one. Crystal.
Oh, dear.
There
we
go.
Fantastic, that. Absolutely brilliant. I was just looking at my Royal Lagnickel brushes as well, which we've got on, are they on this show? No, they were on Masterclass a little bit earlier on. So if you want to pick those up, you've got the 8, the 6 and the 3 within that collection. The darkening edges, says Cindy, really draws your eyes towards the centre. And Sharon Tidmus is saying, love the goodie bag and always need more embossing folders. Cannot wait to see what is in it. If you want to go for the Timeless Leaves collection, details on your screen there. £15.20 or $17.60 is the price on that set. Now, Monday Mega Deals, we can show you a few more of these. The Rocker Blocks are on a brilliant deal. I mean, $7.99 for one set would be brilliant. However, what we're doing here is we're giving you all of the Rocker Blocks for £7.99. $11.19 if you're a Platinum member. Triple points on this as well. It's just unbelievable value for money. And I think we offer you so many different aids when it comes to stamping to make sure that you have got the opportunity to get that perfect stamp each and every time. This is the set of four. And as you can see, you've got your different size rocker blocks for all of the different size stamps that you might have to make sure that each and every time that you are using a rocker block, you've got the correct size for that stamp that you're going with. We then also got in here the two largest sizes for you as well. So if you have ever found it difficult to achieve that perfect stamped image, maybe you have got particular dexterity issues and stamping is a bit of a problem for you, the rocker block system might be the way to go. I think certainly if you chat to any of our guys, if you've got a kind of combination of the stamping platforms alongside the rocker blocks, I mean, really, you are good to go. We can ask Sheena, actually, because, I mean, we see you using your rocker blocks day in, day out. What is it about the rocker blocks that you love personally?
You know what? I get a good image every time. Honestly, you know, repositionable stamping platforms, great for security if you're not sure and you're thinking, oh, you know, I get it, if it doesn't stamp I can go over it again. But I would say 90% of the time never have any problem stamping even the big stamps that I draw with the rocker block. It's that rocking motion that works. I mean, that scene I stamped earlier today, you can't get much more detailed than this scene here, Ben. And everything stamped out the first time.
Yeah,
and it's because of that rocking motion that it happens. If you're just going flat to flat, there's all those contact points that have to just hit immediately. But if you're rocking, you've got only that one axis is hitting every time. So that's all you're looking at, that linear part of the contact. And that's what makes it. It's like the physics of it, you know. When you think of the old die cutting machines, when they first come out, they were rubbish because it was just like a plate against a plate and pressure, pure pressure. And it just didn't, they didn't cut. Once they worked out a roller system and the pressure line was less, then it worked. And that's the same kind of principle as that curved on the rocker block. If you are doubtful, try it. Honestly, I wasn't. I didn't want to know. When Leanne Chivas told me about 15, 16 years ago, she was insisting. And it was like, no, because I'm already doing lots of TV stamping. That's what I do. and I ain't going to break it because it's not broken. I'm not fixing it. But I did it and I went, oh, okay.
Okay.
Fine. Yeah. And it was just, and then I didn't have to carry all these acrylic blocks when I did workshops, like lots of them around. Mm. Everybody just got one extra large rocker block and that was it.
I think as well, read the comments coming through because so many people love their rocker blocks. Beth says, love the rocker blocks. And Cindy is saying, wow, that shadow makes it look so 3D, the previous demo. I'm afraid mine would just look like a big black blob along the edge, says Cindy. I'm sure it wouldn't. And I think, you know, with techniques again like that, you can go back, watch these shows, try. If it doesn't quite come out how you wanted it to come out the first time, of course, you can try again and get it perfected so that it won't look like a blob, which I'm sure it wouldn't have done in the first place. All right, next we are going to have a little look at the Mother Earth collection. Hilary has asked to have a look at the Mother Earth collection. So we've just got the stamps left from this collection. I know there were other components with it. We've had a question from Hilary, who has just asked to see the set. So, I mean, the deal is insane again, isn't it? £15 if you're platinum, or $19 for all of these absolutely beautiful, fantastic stamps. And you're gonna get triple points today as well. So more points than you would have got in the first place. And, well, it's a better than half price deal, isn't it? Particularly if you're platinum. So five stamp sets. This is the free spirit. Within each one, you get, I mean, the artwork is absolutely sublime once again. You get all of these different ladies. And again, I suppose, depending on how you colour them, depending on the skin tone that you go with, you've got the ability, I think, to kind of have these images from, you know, ladies from all sorts of cultures, from all different countries around the world, and some beautiful sentiments to go with these too. So this one, as I say, is Free Spirit. She's got that beautiful floral bouquet in there, and then lovely sentiments like freedom, spirit, peace and love. This absolutely gorgeous second one is the Beauty of Grace. Again, you always get loads of sentiments to go with these. So you've got things just like beauty, simple words like grace, for you, and nurture. This is the one I think we saw a little bit earlier on when somebody who sent in a card, whose name, I think it was Sherl actually, who sent in the card a little bit earlier on. This one's called Namaste. You are precious. You've got love and take care. I love the theme again of like the flowers. It was Joe Holzer. It was a good guess. We definitely had a picture from Sherl earlier on, but it was Joe who sent in the picture. This one here, beautiful again, respect, strength, love. Love again, the floral detailing that you've got all the way through these. And then my favourite within the collection is this stamp set here with the two hands holding the world, which I think is quite poignant, that particular
It absolutely
image.
Is. It says everything, doesn't it? It's like, yeah, more of that. More of that.
More of that. £15, £20, £19, £20. You've got some finished stamps.
I have, yeah.
Well,
let me show you. So this one, I love this. Look at that. That is what all that card's all about,
wow,
isn't it?
Wow.
Yeah. So we've got that, the planet in the hands on the front, and then in the centre, the hands passing flowers to each other, which is again that's all symbology. I mean, you know, it was it meant something to me, and I hope it does to you too. Mm. And then we've got, and you use your inks. So again, as Ben said, like Mother Earth from all different cultures all over the planet. And I love that. Just colour it in, colour it in with your pencils, whatever you like to colour in, and then cut it with your die, and then put the mat behind. So you've got that, and that's it. It looks so classy,
yeah.
But it's so simple. I love that card there. Who was this one? Who made this one? Karen. That was Karen's on the team. And if you want to see any of these, and if you think, I love that, Karen, what did you do? Join Sheena's Inkit and ask Karen. She'll tell you.
Yes,
that's where they hang out. They're there. They're real people.
they hang out.
It's like their virtual clubhouse. And then again, look how cool that is. That's it's about the negative space. So you can see this one here will fit in the corner. Namaste again. Mm. Look at the spicy colours. The way that the background, that mandala, Debbie's used the mandala.
That's
she's doubled
beautiful.
It up so that the corner. So not only do they work as corners, they work as the full thing as well. And then, and this one here, this is Julie's. You can see how you can expand that and how Julie's used the elements, the smaller elements, to make a really cool frame. And then this one, I love this.
Incredible,
I love
that.
The way that the flowers in the hair. Actually, she was the very first one I drew.
Oh, was she?
Yeah, she was. I just love the idea of the flowers and her hair. And she just looks so peaceful and cool. There's that planet again. That was Debbie's card with the inky background. So that's just the inky background. And then just your Royal and Lanacle brush number 6 to just for bleach the clouds out. Really easy to do. I've actually done that a couple of times on shows. And they, again, keep going. And then they use your backing papers for that as well. This one I love. It's so cool. That looks so 70s, doesn't it?
Really does.
I did choose that font because I did think she looked a bit like retro and 70s, that one. And I chose the font to reflect that. So I think that does look of the era. But again, that circular thing with like the shiny... Miricord, I think, adds to that.
That's beautiful.
And then Alaska, but very pretty and delicate, isn't it, that one?
Mm.
And then finally the globe again with a little bit of the glossy highlights there. Yeah.
Well, it was worth doing because Hillary's now said, I've bought them. So there you go. Thank
Cheers,
you, Hillary.
Let
us know if there's anything else you want to see before the end of the show. I know we're going to have a look at the Enchanted Oceans collection with Debbie in just a few moments' time, actually. But before that, let me show you the other two Monday mega deals that we've got for you. Few people have said, what's in the goodie bag? Including Sharon. I can show you what is in the goodie bag. It is an embossing folder goodie bag, and you're not going to believe how much you're going to get in here for £24 or $32. So, first of all, you're going to get the embossing folder stamp and die set. That one is called With Love. So you've got like the two different designs there. And then you've got your die to go across the middle, plus your stamp as well. So you can stamp your little With Love slogan across the center. So that's the first embossing folder that you're going to get within that set. You're then also going to get, I think, one of the best 3D embossing folders that we've done in the last 6 months, which is that beautiful Halcyon Days, which comes from the Kingfisher collection. So already this is looking decent, isn't it? Next up, you're going to get the beautiful vintage parasol from the Garden Party collection. That is included in your goodie bag. By the way, if you do multi-order these, you will get duplicates. Next from the Wild at Heart collection is that beautiful 3D animal print, which is called Perfect Print. Looking good so far, right, isn't it? You're thinking, okay, I've got four here. I mean, I can't be getting many more for my £24 or $32. Well, that's where you're wrong, because you were then going to roar into action with this one, which is called Roar.
Scared me a bit then, Ben.
Did I?
You did, yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, sorry. Moving swiftly on. They've put the Bella Luna Dust Till Dawn
back in the
goodie
bag. Ah, we were going to actually show somebody that as well. I don't know if we'll have time now. Can we have time? We should try that then, Nicola, if we can.
Okay, are we going to do that now, are we? Oh, okay, we are, okay. We've also got in there the All Hallows Eve embossing folder, which is that spooky graveyard. That one is also a stencil set. All of this for 24 quid. We're then going to pop in the Hummingbird in Flight 3D embossing folder as well. All of that, right, £24, $32 is incredible. The next thing you're going to be saying is like, oh, I don't think I could put some ink pads in. All right then. Seeing as you asked, we're going to give you the Bordeaux in your opaque pigment, and also you're going to get in your opaque pigment the Oasis Blue. All of that for £24 or $32 and triple points is absolutely incredible, is bonkers. That is your embossing folder goodie bag as far as the Monday Mega Deal is concerned, but only for the next 24 hours. Well, I say 24 hours, up until midnight, realistically, when the deal ends. Right, so now we are going to have a look at that embossing folder, are we? Okay.
Right,
Sheena, so, we're with you.
Right, so Ben, I'm just cutting a bit of cord because I'm going to do something I have not attempted without a safety net yet with this folder. So a lady asked earlier about the technique I did with the folder at the shop then. And it was one I did on the TV as well.
Oh, ages ago.
Remember,
And
I said, I'll try and show you. So this was the technique. What I did was I took a bit of cord, watercolour cord, and I inked it up, first of all.
ink it up first? Or?
No, I didn't. I didn't ink it up. I didn't. I took the bit of card and I did exactly what I'm going to do now. Okay. And I put it in the folder, okay? And I popped it in my folder, which is a 2D folder, not a 3D folder. And I put it in like that. And then I'm turning it over and I'm going to tape it on the back side, not the picture side, not the side that you see the picture on the reverse side. And I'm going to use some repositionable tape and I'm going to just tape it so that it anchors it in place, because I'm going to want to have it stay where it's at. You'll see, it'll all become clear in a minute. Trust me, stay with it, stay with it. Stay with it, yeah. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like a cliffhanger film, okay? So that's there with that. I'm going to look for now some Finesse Noir Black.
Okay.
Okay, and what we're going to do, and I also need my mats for my Gemini. And I think I just need the two mats. I'm thinking that's all I need. I'm hoping that's all I need. We'll soon find out.
We will.
Will we? It's a 2D, and I think that's right. Nicola's telling me I think that's right. Right, so many options now. Oh, my memory. Okay, so that's ready to go. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my Finesse, which is waterproof. Oh, it's stuck. Hang on. Oh. No, I've got it. Oh, got it. No, I've got ink all over
this
me.
This is Margaret's question. I've just looked back.
Oh, no, I've got ink on me, Ben. That's never happened before.
Oh, what do you like?
What?
Don't get it on your jumper.
I think, yeah, exactly. I'm just saying, I've never seen my hand this clean after a show. So they've permanently got ink on them. So what I'm doing is I'm going across like this with the ink this time, right, across the whole thing like this, just inking the whole thing up like that. And I'm going to immediately shut the folder, shut the front door like that, and then I'm going to put that there, and I'm going to put that there like that, and I'm going to put it through the machine like this. And then we're going to ink it up again, and possibly again.
And again?
I'll still be here tomorrow inking it up. No, maybe two or three times. Then I'm going to ink that up. Can you see? Look.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
Isn't it cool? Yeah.
Looks spooky.
It does look spooky, and it's a nighttime scene, so that works quite well, I reckon. Also, this time I want to go that way because I went widthways last time, didn't I? So I want to go this way this time. Just so that it's the I'm losing the kind of lines a little bit, because the plastic will resist this ink to a degree, yeah. And so this is why I taped it in place, just to keep it behaving a little bit. Have I done it the right way? Yes, I have. But I've got a little bit in there, so I'm just cleaning that up a little bit. So be careful. The reason the Finesse works better for this as well is that Finesse is in a felt, okay, so just be careful, don't be too heavy-handed like I'm being there trying to be quick, because if it was a pigment ink, it's in usually held in a foam, yeah. And foam is squishy, isn't it? So it'll get into all those little nooks and crannies that you don't want it to get into, whereas felt is much more firm, so it skims across the surface, which is what you wanted to do, was to hit the raised bits and not the recessed bits. And then when you lift it out, see, you've got that nighttime scene. It's cool, isn't it?
It's really cool.
And then I'm just going to leave it there because I think we can work with that, because it looks a bit like a chalkboard or something, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And then what you would do then is we'll trim that up and then we'll colour it. So we'll just, so this tape that's on the back there, I'm not going to worry about that too much. I'm going to use this bottom edge here to kind of dictate the straight edge, and then it always looks better when you trim it up. Oh yeah, I think I might have not had that quite straight. I'll blame the astigmatism. We'll end up with a postage stamp size, but you'll get the idea. It's about the techniques, not exactly about always it being polished, but we'll make it look as good as we can for you.
Yeah.
And I think that's not going to look too bad.
Yeah.
I think we're good to go. And then it's just a case of colouring that in. But that's one thing that you
Brilliant.
Can... So all those folders that you've got in that goodie bag...
Mm-hmm.
Hello.
Yeah.
Do the same technique with all of them.
Hello.
Uh-huh.
Nice.
Think of the fun you can have with them. So then, just have a bit of play. So we can colour them in any way you want. Let's put a little bit pink there, bit of purple, oh, bit of green as well, why not, and a bit of that there. So anything you want, but if it's nighttime, usually colours are a bit more bluey if you want to go a bit more authentic with it. But it's a fantasy thing and you can do what you want, really. It's your creation. So that's all you're going to do now is just colour these little guys in like that. And you've got that black outline and you've put it on the right card, it's watercolour card. Mm-hmm. So even though the pressure of the folder has flattened the texture of the card out, it's still clear and nice because it is watercolour card. And then pop a little bit of purple on there to give it a little bit more, you know, shading. You can still get a little bit, you know, arty with it if you want.
I hope Margaret's watching from earlier on. If she's
I
not
hope
watching,
she is. I bet she gave up earlier. I bet it was like, oh, does she ever shut up? Will
yeah,
I ever
is
get
she ever
going
to show me how to probably do like, this again?
Oh, she's probably singing, "Please release me, let me go." Engelbert style.
Engelbert, yeah.
Yeah.
If she isn't watching, Margaret, if you are watching, give us a quick holler. If not, can someone let Margaret know in the comments that we've answered her question?
Oh, yeah, Margaret, you can't ask a question and then go. It's like, if you must know that if you come to the demo day, you can't leave. You're there for the day.
Yeah, exactly.
We'll drag you back.
Once you're here, you can never leave. We've not seen her so far, we reckon, in the comments, so... Oh, now you're asking, Nicola. Margaret earlier was on. Hold the line, please, caller. Hold the line.
Hold the line.
Love isn't always on time.
See, I knew you'd get the reference again, Ben. Oh, no, it's guaranteed every time.
Margaret is. Oh dear, I can't find her name now. No, I want to know for my own. Margaret was on. Oh, she's disappeared now. Where's she gone? Oh, Facebook. There she was.
Find Margaret. Where's Margaret? It's like, where's Wally, isn't it? Where's Waldo? Where's Margaret? We'll start a little campaign. Where's Margaret? Have you seen her, Kimberly?
Oh, she is here, apparently.
Yay, Margaret!
Oh, no, sorry, I'm getting confused now. Rachel's just copied the message from Margaret from earlier so that I could see where she was, so she isn't here.
She's not there.
Anyway, what was I going to say? Oh, yes, we were doing a... When was that? We were doing that quiz the other day, Nicola, and we had a thing about naming all of the characters from the Where's Wally books. Did you know there were so many characters in the Where's Wally books? Yeah.
I just knew the books. That was just Wally was the only one I knew.
Yeah, but then there were loads of other characters who were in the scenes with Wally or Waldo, as he is.
It was Waldo in America, yeah.
There was Wizard Whitebeard, wasn't there? I'm sure there was... Wasn't there Wizard... He had a girlfriend called Wanda.
What? Wally got out much more since I knew him.
The baddie. Anyway...
Oh, Wally didn't get out that much when I knew him back in the day. He's had a life, Wally, since I knew him.
Yeah.
Wally.
Another busy afternoon we had in the office, guys, wasn't it? Not as busy as Friday, no, in between shows. Yeah.
Well, I think that'll give you an idea of how you can work with the folders like that. It's really looking... And then we can paint the trees a little bit. We'll do a little bit of a... Let's do a little bit of... I mean, that's a fantasy tree and a fantasy scene. And it's up to you how you want to paint it. But it makes the folder paintable, doesn't it? Makes it like, you know, that you can put the colour where you want to put it. And you don't have to worry about that black background because more often than not, unless you do it against a green field, which I've just done in me haste. You can't see it. But... It gives you enough of an idea on how you can do it. Oh, man. But you get... I'm putting the brush down and walk away. Put the brush down and walk away. You've got the idea.
And, of course, with all of the different embossing folders that you're going to get in your embossing folder goodie bag, plenty to be playing with. £24, $32. Get your questions in for Sheena, because we are going to be going to our little questions corner very shortly. In the meantime, though, we are going to be having a look at the Enchanted Oceans collection, which I know is proving very popular. These are all the deals for you right here. So we don't have the Showstopper bundle anymore. However, we do have all of the individual bundles for you. So as per the launch day, this is your Ocean Stamp Stencils and Embossing Folders collection. So you get all of the embossing stencils, which I think there were four, possibly five. You've got your seahorses in there. You've got your mermaids, beautiful set of sentiment stamps. Tons in that nine-piece collection for £52 or £67.20. And if you haven't yet got this, it's your last chance to pick it up with the triple points across this weekend. The metal dies collection as well. This contained all of those beautiful mermaid dies, the jellyfish dies. You've got that beautiful shell in there too, and the edgeable is gorgeous. These, again, are perfect to use alongside the illusion film, which you get within this collection too, but you might already have the illusion film. If you have, then get that bundle and you'll thank us later. $41.60, $52 platinum price, triple points on that as well for the final live show. And then you've got your embellishment collection. Just remember, the embellishment collection doesn't contain the illusion film. The illusion film is actually in the paper and card collection, so that might be a bit confusing. But in this one, you do get the ribbon. You're also going to get 12 of those beautiful seashells. You're also going to get the six colours of Duet ink pads as well, six new colours actually. Plus, you're going to get your tricolour aqua pens. You're going to get your shimmer spray, that beautiful, that stunning Enchanted Ocean glitter paste, which is just amazing. And on top of that, you've got your gold gilding flakes kit. So all of that in the embellishment selection is £52 or $64. And last but by no means least is the huge bumper card and paper collection. This contains your 12 by 12 pad, your 6 by 6 pad. As you can see there, you're also going to be getting your illusion film, four colours there. You're going to get your vellum, 24 sheets of vellum. You've also got your resist pad. That's incredible with all of those different designs on. Stunning, stunning, stunning. You've got your linen cardstock in there too, in all of the colours that you'll need to be able to match up with the papers in there. And the acetate, my goodness me, is absolutely outstanding. £64 or $84 for all of that. Again, final chance to pick up the triple points. And don't forget, if you do want to pick and choose still, you do have the opportunity to be able to get all of those items individually as well. But do make sure that you go quickly. And for those of you that are thinking of buying it tonight and taking advantage of the triple points, and indeed for those of you perhaps who already have it, we are going to go back in time and have a quick watch of the lovely Debbie Fisher, who is going to be showing you just how you can get the very best out of your collection. And when we come back the other side of this, we'll be answering your questions with Sheena, so we'll see you in just a moment.
Let's grab another one of the dies that we haven't seen yet, and that's that amazing creator card die.
Oh yes.
Now I'm going to sort of get through this demo fairly quickly because I know it's a lot to it, but I've got lots prepared. Now what I've done is I've created, now you'll need A3 cardstock for this, and I've trimmed this to 16.5 inches by 8.5 inches, and then I've scored at 8 inches, and then I've scored again at 12 inches, and I've scored again at 16 inches, and then I've rotated my card round, and then we've scored again at 2.5 inches. Now that's going to allow me to have this, so I haven't folded it all, so let's fold all of this. So let me just grab my scoring tool. We've got just a little piece here, and then you're going to take that whole piece up from the bottom. So what this is going to create is a box, and all you're going to do, I'm not going to do all of it, but I'm just going to pop my glasses on so I can see what I'm doing. We're just going to trim up these. So in fact, if you come up here like a triangle for those, yeah, it will make those little neat corners. We're going to do the same for that one.
We've just put the 6x6 paper pad at the bottom of the screen, because in the words of producer Johnny, the 6x6 paper pad has gone bonkers, man.
Bonkers.
Yeah, bonkers.
So, and then we're just going to come up this one as well. So that's all you're going to do with this, is to make those little notches. They don't have to be neat or tidy because you're not going to see them.
Yeah.
It's just going to make your box a lot neater. So we're just going to take that up like so. And then that's going to create out box. So that will come round like this.
Okay.
And then that will stick at the bottom. So nice and simple, just like so. And then what we're going to do is take this die. So I did this, so it's 4 inches. So what that will mean is your box will be a 4-inch box. So when you come to doing your lid, and I've done this on the box base side of my board, when you come to do your lid, just add 1 inch each side and then your 4 inches. So it's be 6 by 6 for your lid, but you mark it 1 inch in on your box lid side. And then you'll need a base for this, which is 4 by 4, and you'll just stick that on the inside and the bottom. So all we're going to do with this one is take your actual main die, take the inside cutting edge, we don't want the outside, and we're just going to place that, make sure you've got it the right way around so your seaweed is at the bottom. And then because I know that I want to put a lid on that's going to be 1 inch here, I want to put this nearer the bottom, just to make sure that we've got an even amount of space at the sides and around there. And then we're just going to take that one down. So let's take that down. I'm only going to cut one because just to show you how it cuts, I've already got some prepared. And then I'm just going to literally, let's just pop that. I think that will just go onto there. Yeah. So that will show that. And that's all you're going to do is thread it through like that with onto your board. And then once that goes through, oh, there we go. That's going to cut beautifully into our card.
Yep.
Let's take that one out of the way. So just ease that through because that will cut all that amazing detail. So, and then you just take your poker tool and you'll just take out all those little pieces around. So, and then what you're going to do is you're going to do that all the way along, Ben. So literally take that to the next one, then to your next one, then to your next one. So I'm going to then switch to the one that I've already got. So let's clear those ones up and bring this one in. So, and then I'll explain what I've done so far because there's lots of bits to do on this one. So I've popped it in each one. The outside cutting edge then, if you use your linen cardstock, trim your linen cardstock to 4 inches by 6 inches and then use this die to cut in the middle. Can you see? Cut that middle frame, and that will create a frame to go around each one of these. So I've got one more frame to put on. So I've done this one in a blue, so we're going to pop that onto this side. So that's, then we've got alternative ones, and then you can see that I've put some papers onto the inside, and all I've done with these literally is put them through. But what's nice, because they're double-sided papers, choose one so you get these so it looks like you've got images that you're looking through. But then when you come to putting your box together, the parts that you can see, actually see, it'll look nice inside, which would be lovely.
Is that vellum or paper you've used there?
It's paper I've used.
But vellum would also work,
so
wouldn't it?
So vellum would use, but what I've also done, Ben, is I thought it would be nice to have a window of illusion film. So we're actually going to use our front one with illusion film through it.
Nice.
How amazing does that look? Amazing. So, and this is why I think... Oh, yes.
Sorry, I'm just thinking, is the illusion film, like, is it, what's the word I'm looking for? I can't think of the word. See-through enough? What? Transparent enough? Could you like fussy cut like some of the creatures out and stick them to the back of the illusion film to make it look like they're in the sea, or would you not see them through the film?
Yes, you could do that. Yeah. You could do that. I love that idea. Yeah, absolutely. But that's the thing with a collection like this, Ben. It makes us really be even more creative.
Gets the creative juices flowing, doesn't it?
It certainly does, yeah. You'll just come up with all these ideas. And I love that you'll never run out of ideas.
No.
Because there is so much. In fact, I think you'll get a little frustrated because you want to use it all and you can't use it all at once.
Yeah, so you won't be able to use it quick enough, will you?
You won't be able to use it quick enough. So, I keep saying I'm not surprised. I knew it was going to be busy. I just genuinely didn't know it would be this busy.
I love
the fact that people are loving it so much. It's really exciting for us when we've got things that we love and we just want you to feel that love as well. So we're going to use this on the inside. Now the thing with this one, I haven't got any steel red liner, it's disappeared. So I am just going to use, I think we can get away with just using a tape pen. If you wouldn't mind, I can then just use a piece of card to go to the back here. So I'm going to use another piece on this side. I'm just making sure
that I've got...
Amazing. Thank you very much. Oh, one of each.
You're welcome.
Love that. One of each size. So we use this one. I'm actually going to use it to go round this middle section. So this is your best friend when you're using your illusion film like this, because it won't come away from it. It's really good stuff. So we're just going to place that all the way around on the inside of our box, like so. It doesn't have to be too meaty. You won't even see it once the illusion film's down.
Yeah.
And then our last bit onto there. There we go. Right, so, and then once you've done that, just burnish it down. If you burnish it, it will make sure that it's not only stuck fast, but it's easier to get the backing sheet off of it as well.
Yeah.
So we're just going to do that. Grab, if I can find it somewhere. Oh, no, it's right there. My pokey tool. I always used to place things on the right-hand side, and just lately I've noticed I've been putting it to the left, and then I don't think to look on the left side because I always put it on the right side.
Catching yourself out.
I'm catching myself out, yeah. I'm normally a creature of habit, Ben, and I'm getting out of the habit of putting things where I would normally put them. Right, so we're just going to place that over there.
Yeah. How funny is that? Me and Johnny just had exactly the same bad dad joke.
Oh,
dad
did
joke
you?
Yeah. He just said you need to get back in the habit. Sister Act 2. Love, there's great movies, aren't there? Sister Act movies. Whoopi Goldberg.
Great film. Great film. Right, I'm just going to use my dotty tape pen now, and we're just going to go over all these pieces. Now, when you're using your dotty tape pen, just be careful because you've got a lot of really small, intricate parts. Mm. And the reason I want it on here is to make sure these are stuck down when we put our card on the inside, because then it shows on the outside. So we're going to, again, place this down. I'm going to put that directly over the middle section. I'm making sure that I haven't put any on where I'm bending, where my folds are. So literally going to burnish that down. So that's now the inside of my box. So when we turn that round, you can see how pretty that's starting to look. Oh no, look, rookie mistake I've done there, Ben.
We've got
an upside down turtle.
Well, they sometimes swim upside down.
They do, yeah. I'll have to just swim upside down.
Yeah, they sometimes do.
That's hilarious. Then we've got our box to pop together.
I tell you what, sticking
like
that upside down is what you call a turtle disaster.
Oh, that's good. I like that. Oh, James. Oh, they're all full of the dad jokes today.
Oh,
all
dear.
Full of the dad
full
jokes.
Full of it. I don't know what, but full of it.
Right, so I'm just going to put some of our tape pen down the edges, like so, making sure we've God, that was very good, Jamie. Jamie said you did that on purpose. Very, very good. So I'm just making sure that goes to the edges. There we go. And then just burnish that down as well.
Yeah.
That's going to make sure that comes together. So what we've now got is, let me find my other pieces. So I've done this one, which is my lid. And all I've done for the lid, like I said, is done it 6 inches by 6 inches. I've created a base. So this is going to be my base. It's just a 4-inch base. And then I've just mapped and layered it with something, with one of the cardstocks, which I thought would just make it look nice on the base. And then I've got some nice toppers here to put on the top. So just turning this one round. So making sure we put all that nice pattern cardstock. You'll have so much fun with these papers. They're just amazing. So let's pop that right in the center. And then we can put our lid together. So I'm just going to use those little tabs at the side. Again, I am using the tape pen, which is absolutely fine to use because the glue is very strong. Mm-hmm. There we go. And it's trustworthy is what I'm trying to say. But if you wanted to, you could use a wet glue. It doesn't seem to want to go down that one. Let me just change that out.
Just whilst we're sticking, we are going to have a break in a second to give you a chance to check out. I hate to be bad news bear, but we have got 90 showstoppers left.
Oh, my goodness. And we
90.
Had so many.
We had
Hundreds and hundreds of those. So to say that we've got 90 left is somewhat shocking. So don't miss out. I know there's a few questions coming in. So I'll fire a few of those at Debbie in just a second, just before we have that break. But get the showstopper if you want it. There's 90 more people will get it. Everyone else will miss out, sadly. It's just been a whirlwind of a show, this. It really has.
Yeah, totally. Busiest show ever, I think.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt.
Yeah.
Without a doubt.
So we're going to just stick that to the base there. And then I'm also going to put some glue onto here because we want it all glued down. And then this one on top. And I'm not worried too much about getting it spot on yet because we're going to place, because I've put lots of glue on there, just making sure, might have put just a bit too much along that one, but we'll just put that down the edge. We're going to actually stick this over the top.
Okay.
So that's going to be perfect for the bottom of the base. And that's just going to square everything around. So just making sure I don't get glue everywhere else. And then I know we're going to have a break now, so what we'll do is now we've finished our box, let me just pop the lid on and then we'll come back and decorate it. So okay. Let's turn that one over, pop that one on.
Fantastic.
Oh, there we go. And then we've got, oh, there we go.
There we go. What a brilliant demo from Debbie. And of course, if you've picked up that collection, you can go back and watch the full launch day show, which was Wednesday of last week. But a fab collection if you do like the looks of it. Obviously, we can't offer you the big showstopper bundle, but as we showed you just before that clip, you've got all of those individual collections that you can go for, or indeed just pick and choose. But as I say, go quickly if you want to make the most out of the triple points, and that's across everything that we've got on the show and indeed on the website. Triple points ends at the end of play today, so get shopping and take advantage of all of those points. We've only got about 10 minutes or so left on the show. So thank you for your questions. If you've got any more questions you want to fire in to Sheena, do it now, and then we'll see if we can get through those questions before the end of the show. But we've got about 5 or 6, so let's do these, and then we can tell you what's coming up tomorrow, because Kleagle Beagle is back in the building tomorrow. Pat says, Sheena, how do you prime new stamps prior to stamping? So is there like a best practice for that?
Yeah, because, you know, when they're brand new, they're too clean. And they're really sticky as well, the photopolymer ones. So I found the best way is like get a regular pencil eraser.
Yeah.
And just go over them, you know, just as if you're erasing the front, like not a one of these with pumice in them, like for, you know, the that kind of thing. Just a regular pencil eraser is a good way to just get the surface stuff off them.
Yeah.
I've used like a soapy water before, you know, as well. Just anything like that, just to get the, but pencil eraser works well.
Okay. Question from Jill on Facebook. So again, go back and watch from earlier on. We, I didn't do anything. But Sheena did the draw the line a little bit earlier on. Is there or are there colours that won't work with the draw the line?
They all work to a degree, but some of them work better than others. And I can't remember off the top of my head, but like things like the pinks, you know, like the bright pinks. Sometimes they don't, they'll stain quicker, they'll grab in the card, and the ink doesn't move as well as like the browns and blacks. But you know what, that's the same with watercolours as well.
Yeah.
Like, you know, the natural, like the burnt umbers and things like that, they move easier than a lot of the, like your crimson and things like that, or staining colours. And that's whether it's dye or pigment as well. So it's just an art thing. It's not a brand thing.
Mm.
And it's, you know, artists live with it and work around it and manage it. So what I would say is just get a bit of scrap card, watercolour card, and do a little, just a narrow line.
Yeah.
And try it out with a brush and just see which ones you'll be able to see if you, you know, keep it pretty consistent with the amount of water on your brush and just see which ones move, and then you go, aha.
But it's always with the aqua pens, isn't it?
The aqua markers with the brush. Yeah, the aqua markers are the best ones. Well, we did it today with the sparkle pens. They worked a treat as well. The sparkle pens worked really well.
Yeah.
But yeah, the aqua markers are your go-to for the draw the line. brilliant. And it has to be your watercolour card as well.
It wouldn't work on like your multi-purpose?
It doesn't. The multi-purpose just doesn't have the... it doesn't allow the ink to move as well as the watercolour. It sets it too quickly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hopefully that helps. And as always, if you do try it out and you get a great result, do make sure you tag us in all of your pictures. And of course, you can send them in to the studio as well. Question from Seely, who says, can I ask Sheena, as I'm still struggling to create anything, I think pencils are the best for me. The depth of colour is very vague. So how do I improve this, please? Or have you got any other suggestions that she could try?
Okay, so I'm wondering if vague, you mean that maybe a bit flat. And that's a problem with a lot of people when they're colouring,
yeah.
Is that they look flat. It doesn't look like it's got much shape and form. And you know what? There's two things to think about in colouring.
Okay.
There's the colours themselves, which is easy. We can all see, unless you've got a problem with seeing colours. And then there's what they call the tonal value. So a good thing to do is if you take a picture of something and then you take the on your phone and you change it to black and white, that shows you the tonal value of things, because you've taken away all the colour, and all you're seeing is things that are just from black to white. And to have loads of tonal value in something, you're going to want that range to be as great as possible, from the darkest to the lightest. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. In the old days with the black and white telly, it was easy because you just turned up the contrast and that was it. And old black and white filmmakers, that's why they said they were like masters at their craft, because the films looked amazing because they didn't think about the colour. They just thought about how things would look in black and white. And that's how you would think about your pictures. So what you want to do, that's a good thing to do, is if you've coloured something in, take a picture on your phone and change it to black and white. And then think about if it's, say, a flower, and you look at it and it looks a flat flower. Look at in the depth of the petals. Look at where the petals meet the middle of the flower. And if it's just the same flat colour as the outside of the petals, chances are, you could do with putting some shadow at the base of those petals where they meet the centre of the flower, because likelihood is that there'll be no light in there because the light isn't catching in there. That's where they're all tightly knit together, and the light's more likely hitting the outside of those petals. So straight away you can go, ha-ha, I've detected a part I can make darker. And even on the outside of the petal, it might be that, oh, that could be lighter, and it might be that you get your white pen into the mix. Or if it's pencils, you might get your white pencils over the top of that, or again your white pen, or a little bit of gouache over the top of that. So that's the thing to maybe play with, and until you get used to colour, maybe do what I did earlier and just use a one colour pencil.
Oh yeah.
And play with that one graphite pencil and just look at getting your head around working without the colour to start with, and go, yeah, that get used to where the light is and where the light isn't. And that's a good way to build a foundation. Because even if you did a pencil sketch like that, Ben, and you just did it with you can put a wash of colour over it.
Yeah.
Not even blend it, and it'll still work because you've got the shades underneath with the graphite.
Hopefully that helps. C. Lee, thank you for your question. Three more. Jerry says, do you normally dry gesso on the card first? And also, can you please explain the use and purpose of it again?
Always dry gesso before you do anything to it, yeah. Unless you're going to tint gesso, you can always tint gesso as well. You know when you bought chalk paint, was massive, wasn't it,
for a yes.
while? Well, the thing is gesso was actually means, it's Italian for gypsum or chalk. That's what it means, chalk or gypsum, gesso. Yeah,
yes.
So that's what it is. And it was used in the past. It's used for centuries old. And it was what it is it's a protective layer between the canvas and the paint, which would, back in the day, oil paint, be corrosive. And it would eat into the canvas. So you would have no great master's works of art. You wouldn't see the Mona Lisa hanging there. There'd just be a bit of tatty old frayed bits of canvas there. because she would have eaten into the cloth without the gesso. Yeah. So it'd be like Pac-Man, Lisa. Yeah, exactly. So what would have happened? And it wouldn't have been acrylic gesso back then. It would have been made with like egg and all this stuff. But chalk would have been part of it because it would have protected the layer, and it would also give it ground, like a nice surface for the paint to stick to and cling to. And that's what we use it for still today, is we use it on MDF, for example, to seal the MDF, mm-hmm. to put a seal, because if MDF gets wet, it bursts and it gets all fuzzy, and you don't want MDF to get wet. So you want it to go on and dry it quickly, the surface. So yes, dry it quickly. And then once that's dry, it's not going to be wet because it's acrylic. And it also gives it a nice surface to paint on. But you can also tint gesso with any of your water-based stuff as well, if you want to just put a bit of colour in it, and you've got your own coloured chalk paint as well.
Wow. There we go. That makes sense, says Jerry. Thank you. And probably got time for one more from Sherry, who says, Sheena, what will you be doing for your birthday?
Oh, a bit excited. So I've got shows on Friday. I've got TV shows on Friday.
When's your birthday? Saturday?
And I'm birthday's Saturday.
Right.
So I've got two shows on Friday, and then we're having a little barbecue.
Oh, nice.
On Friday night.
Hopefully you'll get the nice barbecue weather.
I know, really. It could be like with a brolly and a barbecue.
Typical English barbecue.
And I tell you what, we've checked the weather for the holiday as well. And seriously, a plan, well, we're definitely going to take the van. We're coming up north, and we're going to do... hopefully stop up for along the coast. We've got 2.5 weeks booked on a site up here,
yeah.
which is really pretty. We've been to before, so coming back up here on Saturday.
Yeah.
But we're also hoping to stop on a coast a couple of nights as well. But we checked the weather, and we were going to bring everything, like the big tent as well, the
all
big
occasions.
Like pop up and like the kitchen, including the kitchen sink. But now we're thinking maybe just minimalist camping with the van, because it doesn't look good with the weather. But you know what, we'll enjoy it anyway. We'll have waterproofs, so that'll be me, Maria, and Willow, and Gone Feral.
And I've got Gone Feral.
So the show's on the 18th when I show up. Yeah, I might look rustic.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's a twig
like
hanging out.
Twigs and leaves hanging out, yeah.
Think Bear Grylls.
Yeah.
I'll be behind the counter with a little stove going.
Yeah, yeah. Imagine that. If you look anything other than that, I'll be disappointed. Is there anything you've asked for your birthday? Anything particularly you want present-wise, or not really?
I haven't. That was Maria said, what do you want to do for your birthday? And I thought, well, I don't want to do anything big thing. I just would like to go away and have a nice just break and just get away from everything and just enjoy the countryside and just have fun away in the van, and that was it. Apparently I have surprises, but I don't know what they are.
Oh,
I know, but I don't know yet what they are.
Well, I hope you have a marvellous time.
Thank you.
We are going to see you back here
on the 18th, I think it is.
18th, yeah.
Yeah, but I'll be in the area, so we'll just stop in. Like I say, I'll be the lady in the van in the car park.
Yeah.
Just think of me as Maggie.
Yeah, that's it. That was a great film, wasn't it?
Yeah, brilliant.
Massive thank you to Sheena. It's been a wonderful day. Thank you to you all for watching as well. Don't forget to make sure you shop. Use those triple points, because that does end today. But lots still to come. Busy old week on the way here at Crafters TV. I will be joined once again by Craig tomorrow. He's going to be here. We have got a craft along for you first up with those seasonal creator card dies. So if you bought those, was that the week before last? I think it was the week before. That's the craft along live at 1:00. And then tomorrow night, launch party. Loads of ideas with Craig as far as the Arabian Nights is concerned. And also the Enchanted Ocean. Plus, if you picked up the brand new 12x12 luxury mirror car pads that we launched on Cartload on Thursday, he's got some ideas there as well. And again, lots of opportunity for you to be able to pick those deals up if you haven't yet done it. But what a day. Thank you, everybody. Thank you to all of the team. As I say, more than anything, a massive thank you to Sheena. And of course, Willow as well. It was marvellous. She was so cute. But thanks for watching. Enjoy the rest of your Bank Holiday Monday. And Craig and I will see you back here tomorrow for more crafty fun. Until then, bye for now.